The overall objective of this unit is to impart knowledge on online libraries available for visually impaired people. We will also discuss about Bookshare, the world's largest online library for the blind. Visually impaired people have the same information needs as the sighted people. Just as sighted people might read a newspaper, listen to an audio file, or download electronic information from the internet, visually impaired people should also have access to relevant information in their chosen accessible format. Development of efficient library services for print disabled is extremely important because there are significantly fewer books available commercially in accessible formats compared to what is published in print for the general public. There is a growing need to build collections in alternative formats and make them available for visually impaired readers. The library and information communities have adopted a range of standards that facilitate the interchange of library data, promote the interoperability of library systems, and support national and international networks of libraries. Adherence to standards play a vital role in improving access to the information resources in library collections, in cultural institutions, or on the World Wide Web. The IFLA LBS is one of the 37 sections of the International Federation of Library Association, representing over 135 countries in the world, including India. Its major purpose is the development of library services for people who are print disabled worldwide. The section came into existence because of the lack of adequate professional training for those working in libraries for the blind and the need to exchange information and develop common standards. Bookshare is the world's largest online library of accessible ebooks for persons with print disabilities. Through its extensive collection of educational and popular titles, specialized book formats, and reading tools, Bookshare offers individuals who cannot read standard print materials the same ease of access that people without disabilities enjoy. In 2007 and 2012, Bookshare received 2 5-year awards from the U.S. Department of Education, Office of Special Education Programs, to provide free access for all U.S. students with a qualifying print disability. Bookshare has more than 460,000 members and over 460,000 books in its collection. Benetech partners with over 820 publishers to add existing books and new releases to the Bookshare Digital Library. Benetech also partners with libraries such as New York Public Library to bring accessible content to individuals with qualified disabilities. It is an initiative of Benetech, a US-based nonprofit that develops and uses technology to create positive social change. Let us discuss how Bookshare eventually evolved, how it got started. In 2006, experts estimated that merely 5% of print materials worldwide were produced in formats accessible to those with print disabilities. People with visual impairments, physical disabilities, and/or learning disabilities that prevent them from reading a printed book. Bookshare, in collaboration with education technology, publishing, student, parent, and volunteer communities, changed that reality by becoming the world's largest online library of accessible books. Bookshare opens up the world of reading for people with print disabilities. Bookshare offers the world's largest collection of accessible titles. As a result, people of all ages, as well as schools and many organizations around the globe, can access the books they need for school, work, career advancement, skill development, and the simple love of reading in formats that work for them. Now let us discuss the methods to read books from Bookshare. One can listen to books with high quality text-to-speech voices, hear and see highlighted words on screen, read with digital braille or enlarged fonts, create physical braille or large print, read directly from your internet browser. Bookshare is free for qualified US students of any age and school through an award from Office of Special Education Program, non-students and other organizations pay a low fee. Now let us discuss what are the libraries available in India for the Indian audience. So, Gamya Pustakalaya is an online platform that makes accessible content available to print disabled people. The library houses publications across diverse subjects and languages and multiple accessible formats. It has been created by the Department of Empowerment of Persons with Disabilities, Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment, in collaboration with the member organizations of DAISY Forum of India and powered by TCS Access. The Sugamya Pustakalaya is the aggregator of accessible versions of books available in India. This library has been created by DAISY Forum of India to provide access to books to persons with print disabilities. It is poised to become the largest collection of books in accessible formats. It is a one-stop resource for the reading requirements of all those persons who, due to blindness, weak eyesight or any other disability, cannot read the standard print. Bookshare, the largest international online library for persons with print disabilities, is also integrated into Sugamya Pustakalaya. All the titles available in Bookshare library for India can be searched and downloaded through the Sugamya Pustakalaya. Note that the persons without disabilities are not entitled to use the books downloaded from Sugamya Pustakalaya. Sharing or circulation of content downloaded from Sugamya Pustakalaya is prohibited and may lead to legal penalties. They can get access to this library through any of the DAISY Forum of India member organization. For the first time in India, these individuals will be able to log into the website, search for accessible format versions of books created anywhere in the country and download it to start reading. These organizations will be able to upload their books collection to the Sugamya Pustakalaya. The second most important stakeholder is the organizations producing accessible content. These organizations will be able to upload their book collection to the Sugamya Pustakalaya and thereby reach out to the print disabled across the country. They will also get a robust mechanism for storing their books and maintaining membership and book distribution data. These organizations can take up DAISY Forum of India membership to be able to download books from the Sugamya Pustakalaya for their local members or students. They will be able to provide access to enormous amount of accessible material like never before. Mainstream publishers can take up membership of DAISY Forum of India and can directly contribute accessible versions of their publications. These stakeholders are given login accounts on Sugamya Pustakalaya with different privileges. For example, the content producers can only upload books, whereas the persons with print disabilities can only download books. The Sugamya Pustakalaya Secretariat supervises the overall process and has the rights to register organizations and publishers. Although anyone can visit the Sugamya Pustakalaya website and check out the collection of books, the content can only be downloaded when one has the user account with the Sugamya Pustakalaya. Individuals with print disabilities need to take the following steps to create an account on Sugamya Pustakalaya with book download privileges. Open the link shown on your screen. Now click Register as End User. Provide the required information. Make sure all the information you submit here is correct and complete. Choose the library to which you want to send your membership application. Your membership request will be sent to the DAISY Forum of India member organization you selected. You will be intimated by email or SMS when your membership request is approved by the DAISY Forum of India member library. You will then be able to log in, search and download books and have accessible content on your fingertips. The list of all participating DAISY Forum of India member organizations will be displayed. Click on any library name to see more details, for example, the contact details, the number of books available from the library. On any library page, click on Become a Member to start the application process. Fill up the online form and submit it with your disability certificate. The search box is available at all times on the Sugamya Pustakalaya. Type the title, author, or publisher of the book you need and click the search button. Books matching your search criteria will be shown in a table. This table will show the book title, author, publisher, and library name. Without logging into the website, the further action like view book details or download is not available. The advanced search link is available on all pages of Sugamya Pustakalaya. On clicking this link, a form is displayed which allows you to perform an advanced search on the basis of title, author, publisher, ISBN, synopsis, library, language, and education category. On clicking this link, a form is displayed which allows you to perform an advanced search on the basis of title, author, publisher, ISBN, synopsis, library, language, and education category. The more details you provide, the better results you'll get. The different browsing options are authors, categories, language, latest arrivals, textbooks, and periodicals. Using any one of these links, you can browse the books collection available in the Sugamya Pustakalaya. For example, if you click on languages, you'll get a list of languages available in the library. Further clicking on a language, for example, Hindi, will show a list of all the books in Hindi language submitted by all participating libraries. When you search for books after logging in, the title of the book can be clicked to see more details. At the bottom of the page, you can select the download format and then click the download link. You can also request books offline. On the book details page shown here, the request offline link is to be clicked to send a request to the library to provide this book by other channels, such as a CD by post. Please note that when the selected book is from the Bookshare library, request offline option is not available. You can also create and view wish list on the book details page shown here. The add to wish list link can be clicked to shortlist this book for downloading in future. Members can click the my wish list link under my shelf section to see the list of books added to the wish list. Books can be removed from the wish list in this view as well. When the download link is clicked for a book which is from Bookshare library, the user is prompted to provide the Bookshare credentials. When the username and password provided by the user are correct, the file download process starts. An important point to note here is that all Bookshare titles are not available for distribution in India. When the user tries to download such books, an appropriate message is displayed after providing the Bookshare username and password. You can also place a request for a new book. Users can place requests for addition of books currently not available on Sugamya Pustakalaya. To do so, click on the new book request page shown here. The list of books requested by other members is displayed. The status of requested books, whether pending or initiated, is also shown in this table. If the book desired by the user is not in the request list, then the Place New Book Request link should be clicked. Provide the requested information about the book and click Search in Catalog. If a similar book exists, then a list will be displayed. If you are satisfied that the book you need is not in the catalog already, then click the I want to continue with new book request link as shown here. Now provide more information about the book in the given form, and if available, you can also upload a copy of the book in PDF and other digital formats. Click submit to complete the process. So Gamya Pustakalaya has the capability of providing magazines and newspapers in accessible formats. The user can also subscribe to periodicals. To search for the available titles, click on the periodicals under the browse section. Choose criteria for search and click search periodical button. All the periodicals available from Daisy Forum of India Libraries will be listed. Click the checkbox next to periodical name and format that you want and click the subscribe button. You will now receive intimation of release of next issues of the selected periodical. You can also click on My History under My Shelf as shown here to see information about the books accessed by you with date and time. The user can also view and edit his or her profile by clicking on My Profile under My Shelf section as shown here. You can view the following: membership information, status of membership in different libraries and roles, personal information. You can change email address or phone number or language preferences from this section. Disability information. You can also view disability certificate which you have uploaded earlier. Preferences. You can also choose the mode of receiving notifications. You can also apply for membership of more libraries. Individuals with print disabilities have the option of taking up membership of more than one library listed on Sugamya Pustakalaya portal. Individuals may want to do so to have more options of taking books offline from different sources. To do so, click on My Libraries under My Shelf section. Now click on Become a Member of Secondary Library. The list of libraries will be displayed. Choose your preferred library and click Submit button to send your request. First of all, such organizations need to become a member of Daisy Forum of India. For further information, you can look into the link displayed here. Then the following process needs to be followed to create an account on Sugamya Pustakalaya. Open the link shown on the screen. Click on Register Now. Click Register as Library. Provide the required information. Make sure all the information you submit here is correct and complete, since it will be visible to the public. In particular, provide a good description of your organization in not more than 300 words. Provide the logo of your organization in a JPG file of less than 1 MB size. You will need to provide contact details of the key person or the in charge of the library in the next step. On completion of the registration process, you will receive an email with login ID and temporary password. Your membership request will be sent to the Daisy Forum of India, who will approve it. You will get intimation by email when your membership is approved. After this, you should log in into the website. You will be prompted to change password. Your account will be designated the super admin status. You will be able to create other roles for your library. Apart from these initiatives, an online Braille library was established by National Institute for Visually Handicapped, Dehradun, under the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. This initiative was launched on 4th January 2012. It is an online catalog of Braille books, which is being hosted by NIVH, which enables visually impaired persons to ascertain the location and availability of a desired Braille book without going to Braille libraries and presses. It supports over 20 languages, including Hindi, English, Kannada, Marathi, Gujarati, Urdu, Punjabi, Bengali, Telugu, Tamil, Sanskrit, Assamese, and Malayalam.